So we want you to realize that there's going to be some of that. But we have a new way of explaining it to you. And those who have been hearing and have been focusing in this new way are getting results, extraordinary results, easily. So here it is. As you stand in your now, do you accept that you are vibrational? Sort of, kind of. And is it logical to you that you have been offering habits of thought so that you do have a point of attraction? When you think of the people you know, or even yourself, in many cases, couldn't you describe most of them who you know well? Couldn't you describe most of them with a singular emotional word? Sort of like the seven dwarfs. Bashful and happy. In other words, don't you know ornery? Don't you know pensive? Don't you know defensive? Don't you know eager? Don't you know happy? And while everyone you know moves about a bit and could be described in many of these ways, you do sort of have these habits of thought that hold you in those sort of moods, don't you? So we would like you to think of those moods or emotions as vibrational points of attraction, just like the emotional scale that we talked about a few years ago, where there is despair and fear and grief, really low feeling vibrations. And then there is revenge, which is an improvement, and anger, which is an improvement still, and overwhelmment and frustration, improvement still. And then you get into hope, and then you get into joy and eager and appreciation and all those good feeling vibrations. So we want you to think of this grid, this point of attraction, this spinning grid, point of attraction, sweeping around, gathering up all cooperative components and bringing you to them and them to you, because creation is really rendezvousing. It's what it is. Your point of attraction causes you to rendezvous with things that are like you, that are of a vibrational frequency that you are at. So if you think of these spinning grid discs, let's just call it the high-flying disc. That's what you want to be on, that high-flying disc. You want to be on the high-flying disc, but sometimes things have happened that make it impossible in this moment, or improbable in this moment, for you to be on the high-flying disc. So what we are suggesting is that you do it when it's easier. Don't wait until something is manifested and has your attention, because when you're looking right at something that you do not want, there's plenty of momentum going, and there's not enough that you can do focus-wise usually in that moment that's going to change that momentum. And that's why we say, hang on, it'll be over in a little bit. After a good night's sleep, you can take another run at it.